of truth, isn't it? Are we live or are we not live? Well, I was outside putting a grill together today, and the text messages started coming in. And then I got the YouTube alert that my buddy Steve from Boston was online, live. And for 25 minutes or so, I watched him cry his eyes out, and I cried with him during the whole time. And I'm going to make a proper video on Eddie tomorrow or the next day, depending on how long it takes. I have to decide what to do. There quite possibly isn't a bigger influence on me. This guitar is the first and only guitar that I've purchased brand new. And when you buy one new, this is a PV Wolfgang. This is probably 2004 or so. When you buy one new, they don't look like this. They don't have that color difference. When I say that there are 10,000 hours on this guitar, I mean there are 20,000 hours on this neck. It is more than any other guitar, my guitar, and Eddie more than any person was who I looked up to for a whole host of reasons. So I figured what we would do tonight is, since this channel is all about playing the music and playing the live stuff, I would like to invite you all to watch the man and the band work as a band like you've never seen this video before. And if you haven't, you're welcome. It's old, I know. It's from the 80s. The quality isn't great, right? Hopefully it doesn't get taken down. We're going to take a shot. I don't give a shit. So please, no donations, no requests. What I ask for you is do like we used to do. When you had a friend who was... you were turning on to this band, and you'd say, "Look, dude, well, you gotta dig through the ice sometimes. But go old school, because you're 16 at this point, and get an actual Budweiser. Crack it." And you say, I want you to watch the best band in the land. And I want you guys out there to do it again with me. And thank you for tuning in this Tuesday night. And we're going to watch Live Without a Net the full time through. And I want you to think about the things that we talk about so much on this channel. You know, how bands fit together. How melodies connect chords. How... you know, the actual movement of air moves people. How the guitar is literally a part of him, and the channel is wide open. I remember watching this for the first time, and I could have picked a bunch of them, but I remember watching this for the first time, and more than anything, it inspired me just because he was just an absolute gunslinger. There was no thought. It was on autopilot. It was light years. You know, it was screaming away. And just watch it. Just watch it. Mods, thank you so much. Let's bring it up here. Without further ado here. This is Van Halen. This is Live Without a Net. 1986, we're doing the whole damn thing. Eddie, I love you and I'll miss you, brother. make sure you crank this thing. Michael Anthony was great too. Jesus. What a way to start the show. Seriously. See how effortless he was with his picking? It's unbelievable how effortless he was. Unbelievable.
Every time somebody up here yells 5150,
and how good does Michael Anthony sound? How good does the whole band sound?
There's a police code for somebody that's crazy.
I haven't watched this in 10 years. Look at that guitar. Cigarette hanging off the top. Those darts will kill you, man. The battery pack belt. What a change. Look at that shirt. Harmony. Listen to that drop. No, we're going back. We're doing that again. Listen to how big this groove is that Michael Anthony's laying down, and just forget about the notes. Listen to the goddamn swagger that Eddie comes off this bitch with. Listen, I'm sorry, I'm cursing. It's just watch this. This is unbelievable. Steve put me in the mood. Feel. Guys, that was so... That's like one of the best solos I've ever seen him do. God, I haven't seen this since I was... I don't even remember how old. But like, do you see how effortless it was? And how much swing and feel? It's so about the rhythm, not just the notes. It's rhythm first. It's what you get when you grow up playing with your brother who plays drums. Just like Dime and Vinnie Paul. Like, you get that, like, yeah, you get the notes and there's so much in there to talk about, but the swing and the swagger is unstoppable.
Yeah, love has got you now. Look, pick your own back up.
Love you, Mike Bradley. Guys, the band, Michael Anthony is so, so good. Michael Anthony is unbelievable. His high backup vocals, Eddie's backup vocals, and I know Alex is playing the electric drums and all that nonsense, but dude, this band is really, really, really good. Like, I feel like I'm teleporting back to the time when I first got hooked on guitar. And this was one of those videos where, like, you watched 100 times and you were hooked. But you don't go back all the time to the reason you pick the things up. Maybe it's times like this that remind us that that's what we should do. This is totally, totally helping. Let's keep going. Let's keep going. Yeah, yeah. They love it, dude. They love it.
Big Al, are you in full Bo Seamus mode yet or not?
Yeah, I have it on VHS.
Now let me explain something to you. Now, Bo Seamus mode is a mode that we go into when we're partying about as hard as we possibly can. It's only about that much less than 5150, you see.
Bo Seamus mode.
Ladies and gentlemen, the greatest rock and roll drummer in the world, drunk or sober, Alex Bo Seamus Mohaven!
By the way, I have to just say this. This is a drum solo after the third song, I believe. And they each take a solo. If for all you that didn't know, I'm sure everyone knows that, you know, four people in the band, so four solos, and they would space them out pretty equally. But you're talking a stadium rock band. Rock pop band, you know, by this time. Three songs in, you get a drum solo. Pretty amazing stuff. Here we go. Here's the man. Robert Baker, that's exactly correct, sir. is such a good part. This is such a masterful moment. He does this every drum solo.
Yeah.
thank you all for joining me. So much energy. I mean, it's just so good. It's the stuff dreams are made of. This band is just absolutely on fire. Did you hear the drop? Excuse me, at the end, where he does the big horse whinny, and then Alex just, and you know those electric drums sound like absolute thunder through that old school PA. You know that made all the hair on the back of your neck stand up when he dropped it like that. Oh my God. Here we go. Sometimes it just ain't enough. Yes, I forgot. Sammy Hagar could sing his ass off. Cause I've got to have it all. I've got to have it all.
Cause something reached out and touched me. You know now I'm alone. Whoa.
That was unbelievably good. Man. Do I have to say anything?
Okay, New Haven, the lights are on. It's your turn. Come on, right.
Dude, the playfulness. That's the thing, man. They love it.
Come on, you're on TV now. I see some people up there. I see you up
Jeep and Jacks, me too. Me too.
Anybody got any red spray paint? We gotta fix these shoes up here. Come on, find me some red spray paint. What kind of roadies we got down there? Come on. Let them have it out. Okay, come on, New Haven. You take it. You take care of the show for a couple minutes, okay? Cameras on, cameras on the audience. It's all yours.
Take his cigarette butt out, burned out on him. It's so much energy. It's so much energy.
There's some old stuff laying around here. I don't know where this came from.
Thank you, but
I'm sorry.
Guys,
unless
please,
it's yours,
don't
it's yours,
super check.
You're the one that gave it to me. Oh, it's Mike's? Oh, yeah. If it's not mine, it's not yours, it ain't ours. It must be Mikey's.
I mean, when's the last time you were at a concert with this kind of energy?
I'm on to bed! some of these bands. What do you people got to say around here? Look. This shit looks like a cape or something. Hey, Mikey, come on out here. I got some new clothes for you right here, man. Here's your new get up right here, Mike. Come on. It's... Oh, shit. He's already fucked up. Look at him. This is a Van Halen cape right here. Oh, it says New Halen, Connecticut. There it is. New Halen. That's it.
We're just gonna have to tear this play house down!
Cheers. If I didn't know better, I would swear to somebody pissed in this bottle. I wouldn't doubt it, Mike. Okay, now listen. New Halen, prepare yourself.
Dude, what a concert. Are you guys picking up on all the positivity and fun they're having and how loose it is? It's such... Do they even have concerts like this anymore? Is this where people are slamming Jack on stage and dude, this is so incredibly needed. This is so needed. Let's keep going. He's got the Jack Daniels bass. God damn it. I need to watch this every year just to remind myself.
For this pint-sized whiskey-drinking crazy mother right here. Because this man right here is going to take the loudest, the wildest, the most unusual, the most crazy rock and roll bass solo your ears have ever heard in your life. Mr. Michael Anthony!
And he literally just swigged like 10 shots. And there's an hour left in the concert. Look, he's got his poker visor. Watch this.
Thank you.
little foreshadowing to Cathedral. Look at him. Look at him hunting for his prey. My friend. All right. I gotta pause for a second. So, how? Seriously. If you haven't watched this in a while, like, I know that we were all crying earlier today. Like, Steve, thank you so much for tuning in. I highlighted Steve's comment. Steve made a video that encapsulates how we all felt in the very instant that we heard. You know, he was crying, I was crying, everybody was crying. And so if you haven't seen that, go over to Steve's channel and watch his video, because it's like, well, it's what you've been doing already. It's just kind of like looking in the mirror, except it's Steve's basement. But anyway, how long has it been since we've seen a concert with this type of energy and positivity and enthusiasm and fun, just fucking fun, you know what I mean? Like, the reason that people play this stuff, like, it's things are so serious now and so produced and so, like, this is batshit. This is amazing. These are top of the heap 10 level musicians, like, just in amazing form. Like, this is such an incredible treat to watch. And I just wanted to pause and say, one, thank you, Steve, and for making that video and sharing it, because someone had to, and it was you, and it was the most heartfelt, true thing that I think I've ever seen on the internet. That's really true. And wow. Here we go. Michael Anthony, Sweet Baby Jesus.
This next song is extra special. It's one of the first songs that we worked on together as a band, and it's a song that is about aliens, and it's called Love Comes Walking In.
It's a great song.
Thank you.
Listen to Michael Anthony.
Tour since March, and I have no better time anytime than right now, because I get to go sit down, have myself a nice cold one, and listen to the greatest rock and roll guitar player in the world, Mr. Eddie Van Halen.
And here we go.
Thank you.
puts a cigarette on the headstone. Smoke rings.
Oh, my God.
It is unbelievable how good he was. You know, I'm just gonna let it play. I want to say one thing. You know, it's unbelievable. But for me, how do I want to put this? For anybody that hasn't played one of the guitars that he built and hasn't spent a tremendous amount of time with it and haven't gotten hooked with it, the thing that you're likely missing, the thing that you're likely missing is that because he was an amp driver. That's who he was. This was a tool to drive the amplifier. The amplifier's job was not to amplify what's happening here. Everything that he did, the pickups, the boiling of the strings, the tuning, the rock solid bird's eye maple, right? Rock solid bird's eye maple. None of it is to achieve the type of tone that, you know, you see so many people aspiring to these days, and transparency and all these words you hear. Dude had one goal in mind, and that was to drive a fucking amplifier hard, as hard as possible. It was full bore electricity. It was harnessing electricity. And that, more than anything in my youth learning to play guitar, that spoke to me in a way that I've never forgotten. The notes always came difficult for me, and I've always been a rhythm first player. I grew up playing with just a drummer, like he did, he and his brother, and Vinny and Dime, and that whole thing. But the idea that the feel is everything, the swagger is everything, and it's all about driving the amplifier. It's all about cranking the shit out of the power tubes and finding a way to make the amp bark. And we're building guitars around how do we make the amp as forceful of a force of nature as possible. And you're watching him do that with that lead when he dumps the bar. Like, there's so many things about the guitar that you won't get if you don't understand, if you don't get what he's really doing here. That the fact that you have five springs on the back, right? And it takes all the force that you have in your hand to push this down, and you get bruises on your hand at the end of the night when you play this guitar, if it's set up the way he set it up. You get black and blue bruises through here. And it's because the whole thing is just supposed to feel like a rock-solid brick, you know? So that when you're standing on the edge of the stage and everything on your amp is dimed out and you're blowing through tubes every other night or so and you're just squeezing every ounce of juice out of it, that you, like a controller for, you know, a video game or whatever you want to call it, like that you, this is how you make it. You have to earn every little thing, and you get the most control by having the most resistance here, you know, taking all the tone out of your strings and boiling them, dipping your pickups in the wax, you know, again, it four bolt bird's eye maple neck. Like, it is so amazing. I'm going to keep playing the rest of it. Don't bail. I had to get that out. Here we go. So amazing to watch again.
Thank you.
time you need. Yeah! When you talk about love, I'll be right to the core. When you talk about love, do like I told you before. Yeah, you're semi-good looking. You're on the streets again. Yeah, you think you're really cooking, baby. You better find yourself a friend.
Get your pull.
Thank you, New England!
What a great comment. Love you, Dead Stretch. We're on it.
Okay, we'll do a couple more for you, if that's all right. You people ain't in a hurry to get home or nothing, are you? Nobody's out past your bedtime or nothing like that? No? Then let the party begin!
Love him when he plays keyboard more.
Let's dance!
Michael Anthony, tremendous. Every member of this band is an absolute superstar.
Oh, Edward, you should have went to the bathroom before the show.
Hey, look, he's sweating through his whole...
Let's do another one. Let me change the guitars, though.
Look at him spitting his beer. Now, look.
Before we get going,
at the roadie.
We want to thank you people,
you
number
spit
one.
At the roadie.
First of all, a while ago, for making our album number one, okay? That's the first number one for any of us. You people are responsible as much as anybody. Number two,
this show is so
thank you for two sold
great.
Out nights and a great time to video
so
to make
great.
An in concert video. This is great. So, as we jam out this last tune, just remember, let's rock and roll this place. There's a song written by some old friends of ours. Come on, Big Al. You ready?
I forgot they do this.
Let me give back, let me give back, let me give back.
Well, hard to keep a dry eye there at the end. I think that's all I got in me tonight, guys. I really, really don't have the words. But I just thought that it would be appropriate and it would be fitting. It would be okay to just play one of the concerts that made me the person that I am, you know, gave me the reason, hooked me. That watching that transported me back to the time when I saw it and heard it for the first time. And I'm here with you today because of the hours that I put in on this neck. Look at the color of that neck. That is some earned shit right there. That's real stuff. And it's because of that man. Probably more than any other. And I'm going to make a proper video probably tomorrow. I don't know which one I'm going to do because there's so many things to talk about. I don't know. Probably just wing it like I always do. Try to find. Wait for the inspiration to hit me. My phone's dinging. Thank you guys for hanging out with me. It's just such bullshit. I agree with my friend Steve. Can 2020 get any worse? This is such bullshit. And grief is the price you pay for love. That's exactly right. So anyway, the next video that you see from me will be a proper Van Halen video. And I just wanted to share a piece of my inspiration. That was the DVD I would show, or the VHS I would show people, you know, when I wanted to let them into my world a little bit. And what a fucking band. Look how much fun they're having. Look how positive it is. Look how much they love it. It's infectious. You know? It's infectious. It's absolutely unbelievable. And I think I might just leave it there. I'm grateful I got to see them a few times. I saw them with Hagar, saw them with Roth, obviously, like, reunion, whatever. That's it. Love you guys. You know it.